Hello and welcome back to another video in this tutorial series on using Photoshop CC. My name is Justin, and following along with the trend of the last few videos, we've been just altering the mood of photographs in Photoshop. So I've got this picture here, this guy Lee Hayward. I found him in Creative Commons Flickr, okay, Lee Hayward. And we're going to alter the way he looks a little bit. Well, we're going to alter the mood of the photograph, okay? Later on in this series, we're really going to be altering our photographs. But for now, we're just getting a basic handle on how to alter the mood of our images with Photoshop. Okay, so I'm going to duplicate my layer here. There's lots of different ways to do that. I can just grab this and drag it down here and let go, and it's duplicated. I can also hit Command-J and duplicate. I can also go up here to Layer, Duplicate Layer, okay? Look at all those layers. All right, so I'm gonna delete some of those. So that's just a refresher there. I'm going to go ahead and turn this layer off. Okay, so I'm going to, let's work with levels a little bit. So I'm gonna come down here and create an adjustment layer. Create new adjustment layer, okay? So let's pick levels. All right, levels. Now, typically I would be kinda crushing the darks, crushing the lights, and kind of moving this where I want it to go. This guy here, he's so bright down here and so dark up here, I don't really want to bring out a lot of the whites. Okay, so I'm going to kind of just darken it up a little bit, and like so. That's how I want that. Okay, now we can be using, let's see, what should we do? Let's go ahead and throw an S-curve on this too. Okay, S-curve. Now, again, I don't actually know how much of an S-curve I really want. Yeah, maybe a bit. I want to really make it dark. That'll work. That'll work. That'll work. Okay, now, of course, he turned red. So let's go ahead and open up Hue and Saturation. So, again, Adjustment Layer, Hue and Saturation. Okay, and I'm going to bring down the saturation quite a bit, actually. That'll work. That'll work for now. Okay, looking good. So let's go ahead and really bring out the highlights, okay? And that's going to really sharpen this image up. There's a lot of different ways to do that, okay? I'll show you a pretty fun way, actually, we haven't looked at yet. We'll come up here to Filter, Other, High Pass. Okay? And, you know, adjust this where we want it. I think something like that would look good. Okay. And let's see. Whoops, I forgot to duplicate that layer. So I'm going to duplicate that layer again. Okay. There we go. Now I have this layer and I have this layer. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and make sure that my high pass filtered layer is selected. Come up here to my blending modes and select overlay. Okay. Now, see, that made quite a bit of difference, yeah? Okay, so that's looking good so far. What I'm going to do now is actually select my high-pass filter layer here and my picture of Lee Hayward here and select them both and then merge them together, okay? So I can come up here to Layer, Merge Layers, or hit Command-E. Okay, so those layers are now merged. Let's see here. I'm going to select my burn tool, okay? If the dodge tool or the sponge tool is selected, just hold down burn tool. Okay, good. So I'm going to come in here now, and my exposure is set to 20. Okay, it can be set, you know, just go ahead and play with it and see what settings match you. It's going to be different for every photograph, yeah? So I'm going to go ahead and just kind of burn some color back into this. He's so bright right there. Around there, that Adam's apple is just shining, like so. Kind of around here some. Now he's got some shadows here anyway, so I'm gonna kind of make my brush smaller and just kind of bring those shadows out a bit, like so. Kind of around here, make it darker in the eye, just kind of make him look a little bit more intense, like so. Darken the ear. At least that side's pretty dark, but bright over here, like so. Okay. Yes, that's looking good. All right. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Now, so I'm going to actually darken the shadow up under here some too. Okay. Looking good. Looking good. Okay. And let's see here. And so this is actually a technique that I learned from WeGraphics.net. I'm going to go to the dodge tool. I'm going to hit Command plus and get up on this guy's eyes and kind of bring the eyes out a bit. which is kind of cool. You can actually see, well, probably see whoever was, yeah, you can see who was taking the photo. Very cool. Bring the color out in the guy's eyes a bit. And now that we have him up close, I think I want to kind of make it, went back to the dodge tool now. Okay, or the burn tool. Dodge tool is bringing the eyes out. Burn tool is kind of making things darker, and I'm going to kind of make his eyes darker too. Okay, Lee Hayward needs to go to bed. All right, so like so. Yeah, there we go. Darken up that. He doesn't need that bright of a nose. Okay. Let's see. Bring it down. Still such a bright chin. Let's bring that down too, like so. All right, getting up on this guy. Okay, kind of darken the nostrils. In fact, I'm gonna bring this down and darken the nostrils quite a bit, and then kind of hit the shadows under here. You know, for those of you who are into portrait drawing, those techniques are gonna come in really handy when you're working with photographs like this. Okay, no reason for that to be so bright. Okay, let's see what we've done here so far. So there we go. I'm going to go ahead and select this layer on all my adjustment layers, and I'm going to group them this time, okay? So I'm just going to hit Command or Control G. Now they're all in a group, okay? It flattened them, but it really didn't. They're all still in here. Pretty nice. And if you want to get out of there, just right click, ungroup. All right. Okay, so let's go ahead and compare now. So we have regular old Lee Hayward, okay? And then we have very intense, kind of sketchy Lee Hayward, right? Okay, so totally altered the mood of these two, or of this photograph, with just basically some adjustment layers and the burn and dodge tools, all right? So, yeah, look at that. Big difference. Nice guy, kind of sketchy guy. All right, yep, I'll catch you in the next video. Thanks.